Hello students, welcome to my channel Study Well E-Learning. Today we are going to discuss about the anatomy of flowering plants. Ye chapter hai, this is chapter 6 in class 11. Okay, so we will be seeing here ki what is anatomy. Anatomy means the study of internal structure. So here we study the internal structure of a living being. And so this is anatomy. So if we are dissecting an animal, we are simply looking at the organs inside an animal. Suppose we dissect a rat or a frog, and we see, suppose we are dissecting a frog and we are able to see what is inside the frog. We simply dissect the frog and we see that there is the digestive system, there is we can see the food pipe there, we can see the stomach there, we can see the intestine there. Okay, and then we can see its kidneys, we can see the excretory system. Okay, this is the study of anatomy. Okay, but here we are discussing the anatomy of plants, especially the flowering plants. So in case of plants, what is there? If we go and try to study the internal structure, try to study the anatomy, then we have to use a microscope. So in case of plants, we need to use microscope. A microscope is needed to study the anatomy of plants. Okay, without a microscope, we cannot study the anatomy. See, if we have taken a stem, okay, and we are cutting a transverse section, this is the stem, and we are cutting the transverse section through the stem, and this transverse section, we can't see anything with naked eye. Okay, we are not able to see the structure properly. We are not able to differentiate between the different tissues just by looking at the transverse section of a stem. Okay, so we require a microscope, and this microscope requirement means that we are going to study the tissues. So in case of plants, we study tissues of plants using a microscope. We are studying tissues and we are using a microscope to study this. Okay, and this we are studying the internal structure, but without a microscope we are unable to see anything clearly. So in case of animals, we see the kidney, we see the heart, we see the stomach. That is the study of anatomy. We can see study anatomy without using any microscope. But when we use a microscope in case of an animal, suppose we are taking the kidneys out and then we are cutting a TS, transverse section of this kidney, and then we can see the what is inside the kidney. We can see the internal structure using a microscope. Okay, here we need to use a microscope. So when we are using the microscope, we say that we are studying the tissues. And if we study tissues, study of tissues, okay, this is called, we call it histology. We call it histology. Histology is the study of tissues. Okay, so in case of plants, let's see what happens. We have to use, without any microscope, we cannot study the anatomy of plants. So in case of plants, histology is also known as microscopic anatomy or microanatomy. Okay, when we study histology in case of plants, histology is microanatomy. In case of plants, both the anatomy and histology is same. when we say the anatomy of flowering plant, it means that we are going to study the histology of flowering plants. Okay, as we compulsorily using, we are compulsorily using a microscope, and we are actually studying the microanatomy or histology. So in case of plants, we can say that in plants, anatomy means histology. Okay, it's equal. So in case of plants, we cannot study anatomy without using a microscope. That's why we are studying the histology in the case of plants. So when we say anatomy, it is equivalent to histology. But in case of animals, these are two different branches. Okay, two different, there is study is different. Okay, so this is about the anatomy versus histology. In our next lecture, we will be studying more about anatomy of flowering plants. So thanks for watching. Please do subscribe the channel and do like the video. Thank you.